Welcome, Jay White, Dylan Stilley here. Big district matchup between the Elk City Elkettes and the Weatherford Eagles. Getting ready to get started here. Got it going in time to get a little national anthem. Big district matchup, Dylan.
Yeah.
Weatherford's leading the district right now with Elk City and Cash tied for third. Weatherford was the one that gave us our first district loss, so we're going to have to hopefully avenge that tonight. Be nice.
Yeah, we'll need to. I mean, at least to secure like the third place.
Yep.
To avoid the bye district.
Right.
That's really. I mean, there's a small chance that we can bump up to a two.
Right.
I think Weatherford would have to lose to us and then lose to Cash, but then would come in the run differential. So we'd have to beat Anadarko in our last district game by
a bunch,
you know, to surpass that.
Early on, we were way ahead in the run differential, but that has changed a lot lately.
Yeah, and it just depends on when you get some of the teams at the bottom of the district.
Yeah.
And we still have one with Anadarko and one with Clinton.
Right.
So, I mean, we can do it.
We could both of those games we scored quite a few runs in.
So yeah.
Those Ophir games that we had in there in the middle really.
That hurt us.
That hurt us pretty bad. Not only losses, but not scoring any runs.
Yeah, we'll really need we'll need Cash to beat Weatherford for us. And I don't know. It's Tuttle. I don't know who they have left. I mean, they can get a third loss as well, but. See who they have on their schedule.
All right.
They have Cash and Cash. So a loss to Cash would help us, but also help Cash.
All right. We're going to get started with the national anthem here, folks. At this time, we'd like to introduce the Lady Eagles in the starting lineup first.
Number 4, hold, number 99, Aubrey Bowles. Number 5, hold, number 9, Brianna
Woo. Love it, man.
All right.
So Jay,
glad we got that done.
Let me ask you this. What do you think the keys to winning this game is?
Getting on Teasley early. I think she really shut us down with that rise ball last time we played. And, what was it? We had four hits, I think, the whole game.
A lot of strikeouts.
A lot of strikeouts, four hits. We just didn't put the ball in play. And so, we did a good job keeping them to not a lot of runs either, but we scored one. It's a big game. We're going to have to put the bat on the ball, get some stuff in the outfield.
You're right. Strikeouts, we got to keep those down. Just like with any game, strikeouts or errors or walks, mm-hmm. we just can't do those things.
No.
And, with teams that are this evenly matched, I think, that's what's going to come down to is
– Right. No doubt.
Walk, strikeouts, and errors.
Well, we're getting ready to get started here. Got a rowdy crowd. I think there's a little trash talking going before the game, I understand.
Oh, no, really?
Oh, yeah.
Man. Up to bat is Chisholm's up to bat. She's leading off of Weatherford. She had the walk-off home run against Tuttle a few weeks ago.
Really?
Yeah. I think they might have been in extras.
Yeah, it seems like it was in the 10th inning.
Yeah. I love the competitiveness of the top four teams in this district.
Right. All pretty evenly matched.
Yeah.
And according to some, think that it's by far the best district in the state, especially you put the top four.
Yeah, I agree with that 100%.
Good pitch there by Aubrey. Coming back, 2-1 to the counter. Harley Chisholm.
Wind's blowing hard, blowing out.
May see some today.
Yeah.
Aubrey really trying to keep it low right now. 3-1. I think it's also imperative for Aubrey to get ahead early.
Yeah.
Get them second guessing and not give them pitches they can hang on like that right there. Line drive by Harley there.
We're expecting a stolen base. Have you seen Chisholm run? Did you see
him? Yeah. Birdie cheating over a little bit. Looks like it, maybe. Shading over. I wouldn't call it cheating, but shading over. Expecting it.
Good pitch.
Good pitch. Strike one.
Okay, we got something going on here. Probably a bunt and a steal or.
Bunt. Fouled off for second strike. And that takes that out of play, Dylan. Takes that bunt out.
It doesn't take the steal out.
No, but it takes the bunt out a little bit. Foul back.
That's a big battle.
Yep. Winds are getting it pretty good out of the east. Southeast today, so. Got her swinging.
Good pitch. Down at the knees.
Yep. Diving.
Yeah. So we got some football boys piling in.
Yep.
Got some young Oilerettes watching the game. Some of the best softball that you'll get in Western Oklahoma right here.
Right. Maybe all of Oklahoma. Maybe. Yeah.
Pretty close.
Yep. Good job by Abby. Keeping that in front of her. 1-0 to the batter.
She's gone.
Yep.
Yeah. Not much of a chance there.
No.
She stayed low. Looks like she might have got a little shaken up there on her slide.
1-1 to batter.
Good pitch. Chisholm, she has two twin brothers, and they're both athletes, play football and basketball.
Good walk to Marley.
Got a force in your bag now. So who's up here is number 12, do we know?
No.
They don't have names?
No. I was hoping to catch Hunt before he left with the lineup. Do you still got a Weatherford lineup?
I want to say we got an old Weatherford's one somewhere. I don't see one. That's Tuttle. Oh, let's get the out. There we go. Nice job.
Yep.
Probably the right choice by Riley just to go one right there.
Right. Especially with the speed you got.
Yeah.
I like going there at first because if they're going to try to come home, you know, you got a better chance than if you go to second. Fouled off.
That little ball hit right there could have been a lot of trouble.
Yep.
If it hit the line, it would have just kind of rolled all the way to the fence probably.
Yep.
Two, maybe three runs could have scored.
0-1 to the batter.
Oh, nice pitch.
Aubrey. Brian LeGrand, the umpire behind the plate.
Yeah.
Joey Bell's in the field.
We don't get him too often.
Yeah, be doing a great job.
Yeah, keeping those balls in front, saving runs. Good pitch.
Yeah, good pitch.
Brave, brave. Lots of guts to throw that pitch right there. But
good job.
That was awesome.
Great changeup.
Yeah.
We'll be back in a minute.
Tips Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
Welcome back. J.Y. Dylan Satilli. Big district game here between the Elk City Elkettes and the Weatherford Lady Eagles. Big, big first top of the first there for Elk City. I mean, that's a deal you get your head down early if they get those two runs in. And
it seems like anytime Chisholm gets on, they score. And we managed to keep her at third.
Yep. Yes, it was huge, and man, what a pitch by Aubrey were there, that final strike, that changeup that just dropped in there. Does a good job of hiding it, not showing it. Hard to pick up. Ella Satilli leading off. Ella's been
still on a hot streak.
Yeah, doing well lately.
Yeah.
Ella's hitting 463 right now. With six doubles and nine triples.
Man, I'm gonna get one of those triples right here. Let's get it going, birdie.
Hurrah. Looks like Marley's bringing it.
Yeah, that ball just jumped, didn't it?
Yeah. Rise ball that she's got was really hard for us to hit. Hopefully we can manage to find a way to. Good job, birdie, holding off on that one.
I'm surprised nobody tried to, contest that.
Right. That was close, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
In there for a strike. Two balls and strike to Ella. Lead off for Elk City here. Fouled that back. 2-2.
Well, it's the same thing with birdie as it is with Chisholm. If she gets on, we usually find a way to score.
Good eye by birdie right there.
That's a pitch we were chasing last time we faced them.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That, you know, that ump was calling a lot of stuff high last time, and it felt like the girls felt like they had to. There's a double. There's a hit.
Yeah.
I mean, it's over second. I was like,
yeah.
Nice hit.
Great at bat by Bird.
Yep.
Good discipline.
We got to make Marley work.
Yeah.
Get deep in the count.
You know, key is laying off that rise ball.
Yep. Hopefully they've talked about it.
Yeah. I've seen Murray talking to him just.
Yep.
Here is their. As Birdie was hitting.
Riley did manage a couple of the hits when we were at Weatherford.
Yeah.
Tried bunt. Dropped ball there. Missed it. I got a feeling they're going to try it again.
Yeah.
Riley usually gets it down. Oh, no.
Oh, ball out of her hands.
That's where you go down for that rise ball, and it just drips up enough, and you pop it right up.
Yeah.
Tough pitch to get down on the ground. Rover.
Woo. They didn't go off the plate or anything.
Nuh-uh.
I'm sure Riley was expecting the ball with 0-2.
Yep.
That was right down the middle.
Yeah. Got caught trying to cheat there. Abby rips one, hits the light pole.
Yeah, Abby got herself out of the slump this last game. You get to keep that going.
Little bit of time at the mound with the catcher and pitcher here.
That ball they took out there might have been a little too new for her.
Yep. 0-1 to Abby Joe, one out.
Abby calls for time.
Yep. Marley shook off the pitch, and Abby saw it and called time.
Oh.
Good throw by the catcher. Got birdie trying to steal there.
Yeah, change up, hit the dirt.
Yeah. Good job by reading it, but it just, man, it came right to her.
Yeah. Yeah.
She didn't fumble it at all.
Birdie might have been a hair late reading that. Well, just takes one swing.
Yep. Outside. Good job by Abby.
Yeah.
And they're taking that much time.
Keep the pitcher out of her rhythm and
yeah.
Not let her slow ball you a little bit.
Yeah. There's a change up outside.
All right. Avenue's just set on her pitch right here. Go
right.
Drive it. I can also see Morris not really wanting to give her something to drive.
Right.
So.
Full count. Stands are filling up nicely.
Yeah, I need those boys to get a little rowdy.
Yep. Fouled back. Looks like that caught the catcher on the hand there a little bit. She went to reach for it.
Oh, did it hit her fingertips,
yep.
You think?
Yep. She's rubbing that hand.
Mm.
Got her. Woo, tough pitch. We'll be back. Dylan Stilley here at the Elkett Softball Complex. Big district game here. Weatherford Lady Eagles and the Elk City Elkettes.
It's going to be a tight one, I believe.
Yeah, top of second, 0-0. Weatherford had a couple of girls in scoring position. We were able to get out of it. See if we can keep rolling here.
Yeah. Who we have here? This Morris?
Yeah, I believe this is Morris. Ricky Morris's daughter, third baseman. Daisy's her name.
Daisy. Daughter or granddaughter?
Daughter.
Ooh, nice hit.
Nice hit, opposite direction. Fair.
Get her, get her, get her, get her.
Oh, man, overthrew her.
Oh.
They were in, Jill was in a rush to get it in, didn't make a good throw. She saw her turning and kind of rushed her throw. I mean, she did a great job getting it in that quick.
If the ball would have been down,
yep.
You know, a few feet where Ella could have grabbed it, Mike could have had a tag.
Yep. Lead off in the second on for Weatherford. Great pitch right there by Aubrey.
We're looking at a bunt, maybe?
We're expecting it. Elo's creeping up.
Oh, nobody there.
Where was Riley? That's not like her.
No, she... I don't know.
I don't know. That's not like her. That's unusual. That's that error we don't need.
Go, KJ! Go, KJ!
Lord.
Stretching out, great hustle by Abby Joe right there.
Yeah, when you got that first and third play called and you got it going to third, well, there we go.
Little coaching there by Ricky. First out, popped up, bunt.
That was huge.
Yes, runners on first and third for Weatherford. One out.
Take it away.
Great pitch by Aubrey right there, swinging his first strike. I thought she hit that.
I did too.
I thought, but she must have golfed it off the ground.
Yeah.
Had Abby behind me and.
Wisely put on Chisholm.
Yep.
Two outs. Yeah, Birdie come up with another of those jumping plays. She gets those. Pops from her dad.
Yeah, I know. I've heard.
Yeah, right. I can barely touch Ned anymore.
There's a tough one. Gonna fall in. Little blooper down the line, left field. Weatherford's the first on the board today with two runs.
Well, I mean, it's the right plan to get the bases loaded up with their best hitter.
Yeah.
Sometimes it doesn't work out.
Yeah. Wasn't a solid hit ball, but it just fell in the right spot. That one fouled back.
Got Marley Peasley.
Tough one. Aubrey throws a lot of them down in the dirt. Unfortunately, that one got away a little bit from, she was capable to keep in front of her, but man, they're fast.
Good job, Riley.
Well, I'm lost here. I'm just sitting here looking around.
Yeah, just me too.
We'll be back in a minute.
If your garage door looks like this, there's only one person to call. Red Dirt Garage Doors. They'll literally get you back on track and rolling up and down again. Red Dirt Garage Door does residential and commercial sales and service, serving Southwest Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. You can call for a free estimate at 580-482-6369. That's 580-482-6369. Red Dirt Garage Doors, keeping you on track and the garage door looking good.
Dylan Satilli, Jay White here. We are in the bottom of the second. Batter is Aubrey Pogue. Aubrey's batting 478 right now, Dylan, and has... 15 doubles.
Whoa.
Did you know that?
No, that's pretty good.
Yeah. And she's not the fastest thing out there, so that means she's hitting the ball deep and hard.
She's been hitting a lot of them in gaps.
Yep, doing a good job.
Maybe she can keep it up.
Yeah. Another one right here. She's got the swing for the rise ball. talking about district standing, Dylan and I were earlier, you know, Weatherford's leading the district right now. And Tuttle second, we're third, tied with Cash. So really, really need to do something here to not have to play the by-district game. Yeah. Because when you get in playoffs, just anything can happen.
Yeah, you know, so say if we lose this game to Weatherford, then we're going to hope that Weatherford beats Cash.
Right.
Because I'm pretty sure we'll probably have the run differential on Cash. We scored a lot more runs than they have.
Change up in there for a strike, that, 1-1.
That two change ups in a row?
Yes. First one's in the dirt, that one right across. That was another one, wasn't it?
Yeah. A lot of respect for Pogue.
Yep.
Keeping her off balance, huh?
I bet there's gas coming this time. What do you think? I don't know, though.
The rise ball that rose.
Yeah. Rose right out of there.
Yeah.
3-1 to Aubrey. See if she can get us lead it off. Lead it off?
Lead
outside.
Off. Got it. Got us a runner. Wow.
Gonna have Asia Maddox as a courtesy for Brian. I was looking at Brian. For Aubrey.
Great job by Poe getting on base.
Yep.
BB can tie it up real quick. It just takes one swing, one pitch.
Yep. Middle of our lineup struggled really bad when we were against Marley. I think
Marley and the catcher always like to talk about stuff, don't they?
Is there a rule how many times you can go? I don't think the
not on for the players, but for the coach, there is.
If he goes more than the second time, doesn't he have to change pitchers?
You're
is
right.
It the second time in an inning?
In an inning. Oh.
In there for a strike.
Get her to bunt, maybe. Brown's looking like, wait, what? What? Me? Had a steal on.
Something about we didn't get a sign.
Well, darn.
Dead gum, we don't need base runners getting thrown out. That's second one.
Yeah.
That's tough. 0-2 to BB. Fouled that one off. Oh, still a count remains 0-2.
Ah,
there's that rise ball. Up was, around the eyes.
Yeah, but he was a little anxious.
Yep.
Get some with two outs.
Yep. Two outs. I don't like this. We're down already. Three up, three down. Outside if we're not careful.
Well,
Jada Kimball.
Watching Teasley pitch. He's,
yeah.
She competes, man.
Oh, yeah.
She's serious. She's all business.
Fouled off of Jada. One and one to Jada. Called a strike. right there at the knees.
Yeah. Good call by the Blue.
Yeah. Brian does a good job. He's got a pretty straightforward strike zone.
He doesn't seem to lose focus like I see a lot of umpires do. They get back there. I know I've umpired before, and sometimes you just kind of get caught watching what's going on in the game.
Right.
But he's business. He knows what he's doing.
Got him swinging. Tough one. We'll be back. Top of the third.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back. Jay White and Dylan Satilli, Elkhead softball. Big district game. Weatherford Lady Eagles leading the Elk City Elkhead 2-0. We're in the top of the third.
Yeah, Weatherford, they came to compete, didn't they?
I'm telling you.
They're in it.
That went high for ball one.
Yeah. Poe got to show him her rise ball, too.
Yeah.
Oh.
A good pitch.
That was a nasty pitch.
1-1. Another nice pitch. Mixing speeds up.
Yeah, stay inside on her.
Yeah. One ball and two strikes. Right, little there. Chopper to birdie.
Nice play.
Good play. Well, the first out, we'll take them like that all day long.
She did a good job charging that ball.
Yeah, you
staying low.
I mean, a little dribbler like that, you can't wait on it to come to you.
No.
They're too fast down the line. Another high one there.
Nice.
Nice pitch. Painting that inside, isn't she?
Yeah, that may be a key to getting some of these girls out.
Yep.
Because they do a good. Oh, she's off the plate now. They do a good job.
Yep.
Hitting those outside pitches.
Two balls and a strike. The batter. One out. Top of the third. There's another inside pitch, fouled back. 2-2. Little change up in the dirt.
That's like, full count, Jay.
Yep. See if we come at it right here. Yep.
Oh, wow. Ooh. Maybe just a little inside.
Looks like we've lost our – Dylan, we've lost our
– what did we lose?
Uh-oh. We're not. Hang on a second. We're in, out of battery.
Oh, we are?
Yeah. You're good. The button got turned off on us. Too many technical things for me. Good pitch by Aubrey right there. Get ahead of Morris.
Morris, didn't she hit down the line last time?
No, I think we went. She's the one that hit the flare. They were telling you. Yep.
Okay. Bunt. Oh.
Wow, bunt on note. Isn't that, wasn't it 0-2? Or was it 0-1?
0-1.
I guess it was 0-1. That's 2.
Yeah. Element of surprise.
Yeah. 0-2 to Dacey.
Got caught.
Good job by Jada.
Oh.
Good job. She came a long ways, didn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Two outs. Top of the third.
Nice call.
Pitch. Nice pitch.
Abby, good job helping Pogue out on that one.
Everybody can hear the crowd behind us, I think. Little change up in the dirt.
I like that they're throwing it. I just wish we could get them out of the dirt a little bit.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, Jill. Woo!
There we go. Good play by Jill.
Yep. Wow. Big out right there. He sucked in and then and that was close, yeah. Buddy. We'll be back in a minute.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space, and we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back. Jay White, Dylan Satilla here. Elkett softball, big district game.
I have a feeling in my gut we're going to get something going right here, Jay.
Do you?
Yeah. Yeah.
They haven't seen Jara. You know, she didn't bat. I don't believe in the. She just now has kind of broke into the lineup.
Yeah.
And been
and
doing really well
in the JV games.
Yeah. Got a little storm brewing out there on the state line. So.
Is there?
Yeah. Little thunderstorm, got a wind coming in off of it.
Well, I seen earlier that there's going to be some north and in the panhandle of Oklahoma. I didn't really see any down this way, but.
Coming just south of Shamrock right now.
Wow.
So. Bottom of the third.
Hopefully get a lead and get this in, huh?
Yeah. Oh, way late by Jara. Swinging and miss.
You know, this is definitely something Caller hadn't seen yet this year.
She hadn't seen a pitcher like this yet.
Yeah.
Coming right at her.
Yeah, she just needs to keep her head on it. Life for her shorten up right here and just put it in play.
Job laying off.
Yeah, good eye.
One to two. One ball, two strikes to Jara.
I do like the aggressive cuts that Jara was taking, though.
Yep. She got her swinging. She's going after. She was more in time that time, I think. Was it foul tip? Just
it looked like it tipped a little.
Seemed like I heard it just come off the bat a little bit, but caught by the catcher.
Yeah.
So
She saw a little bit longer there and slowed it up, slowed her swing up just a little bit.
One out. Emily Lawrence is the batter.
Good eye.
Good eye, a little bit outside. See how Elo does. We struggled with really bad against Marley Larry Weatherford, so. One and one to Emily.
Yep, she needs to go straight to it.
Yep, we just talked about that, her and I did. Good eye.
So we got Metter.
Yep, Metter's in the lineup today. Three and one. Good job by Emily.
Her and Madison are DP flexing with each other, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, she's in the field and hitting, so it would be DP flex Jarrah and Madison.
Yeah.
Oh, there's ahead. A good hit.
Yeah! Overhead. No. Get back. Quick. There you go. Good job, Elo.
Good job.
Great hit. Wind carried a little bit over the center fielder's head.
Yep.
I'd like to see it go out so we get that run quick, you know.
That's what I was just telling Elo. Take a tomahawk chop straight to that right ball.
I didn't see the swing, man.
Dude, it was you come down on that thing, get that backspin, and you get a rise ball off the bat, and that's what it did.
Yeah.
And it just, woof. Man, it's perfect job. One out. See if we can get something going here. Come on, Jill.
Jill, she's got herself something to prove here. You know, she knows she wants to prove it.
Yep.
Yeah. Good on Coach Murray giving her a chance to prove it.
Right. She got a... Tried for a bunt there. Yeah. Now we're 0-2.
All right. You got it, Jill.
Yep. Confidence, baby.
Good eye. We're doing a better job laying off the rise ball for the most part.
Right.
We're okay. We still got Bird and Riley and everybody else coming up.
Back to top of the lineup. Two outs. Top of the lineup. Ella Satilli's up. We need that opposite direction double right here.
We just need to clear the fence as well. Mm-hmm. Ella's got to see the ball a little longer. She pulled her head a little early.
Mm. Took one off the elbow.
She's just limping it up there.
I see the red mark from here. Oh, that hurts. Hey, babe. Hey, babe, what you want? Got somebody walking through my cords here.
All right. Let's
see what he's going to do.
We'll get Riley zoned in and see if she can
do something here.
Yeah.
Come on, Rouse. Fouled that one back.
Yeah. We'd love for something to happen here and then get Abby Joe up as well.
A little two-out rally. Good eye. Change up there.
Yeah, good job laying off that change up.
Oh, no, 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 no. A little pop-up to shortstop. Isn't going to do it, folks. We'll be back in a minute. Top of the fourth.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Welcome back. Dylan, what are you thinking?
We had a good chance to score some runs. Would have liked to scratch one across.
Right.
Keep it to a one-point game.
Right.
We were in a good spot, with Riley and Abby and Birdie before that, to get those runs drove in.
Right.
We just didn't execute. But it's just now the fourth inning, so we still got some time, Jay.
Well, Weatherford's only got one district loss for a reason.
Yeah, they're good, man.
Yeah.
And they're getting better,
Yeah.
They're gaining the confidence that's needed to win a district like this.
Fouled back, 0-2.
Well, I really don't want to get back on a losing streak with Weatherford, though.
No.
We finally broke it last year.
Right.
Right here. And that was one of the best atmospheres.
Got her.
That was a Like I was saying, last year it was one of the best atmospheres that I've seen.
Getting a little rowdy, which we needed.
Yeah. Seems to have affected the Lady Eagles. Mm-hmm. Eaglets.
Lady Eagles. Weatherford Lady Eagles.
Seems to affect them a little bit.
Oh, really not fit.
That changeup getting into that wind and it's just kind of pushing it to the east.
Right. Three in a row right there. She finally laid off of that one.
I think the football boys are saying that was a bad call. I don't know what they're seeing.
Well, they're going to argue everything.
Yeah. We don't want to get our umpire rattled. We want to get these Weatherford girls rattled. We need to stay on the good side of the umpire.
You're a fine one to talk, Dylan. Got her swinging. I don't know that that's where Abby was set up outside. It came inside, but it worked. Two outs. Back to the top of the lineup, though.
Yeah. Here's their super sophomore.
Yep.
Harley Chisholm. She's been visiting a lot of big schools getting recruited. She's been going on some visits.
Her dad's a recruiter.
Yeah, he works for NSR.
Yes.
Yeah. Got a 1-1 count on her. This is where we want to be rallying.
Another one
right
low.
Here.
Got to get them up a little bit. Three and one is the count.
Oh, that's trouble on Elo. Oh, gosh, he's fast.
Oh, man. Jill's there backing it up, coming off the fence. She's going three. We better get it in. Ooh. Had to rush the throw. Base hit to base error. She can fly.
Notice how low she just stayed to the ground the whole time.
Yeah. Good pitch. This is the girl that hurt us last. She's the one that had the two RBIs.
Yeah, when we potentially walked.
Yep. Got her. Aubrey hit 0-2 here.
Can't lose her. Got her.
Oh.
Oh. Ryan says no. Abby set way outside, but it looked like she came back across the plate to catch that ball.
Got her then. Good job, Aubrey. Woo! We'll be back.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run, with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back. Elkett Softball Complex, big district game here. Elk City Elkettes, Weatherford Lady Eagles.
What exciting atmosphere, Jay.
I mean, it's tough.
I like it.
I do, too. I think I do. I don't know that I don't like
I don't like the score. But
yeah. We knew it'd be close. You knew that we'd have a tough time getting – runners.
Oh. That would have been good.
Yeah.
Teasley wasn't sure if there's a throw down or not. Almost got her.
Abby Joe's up. Abby's batting. Let's see. I got moved around here. Abby Robbins is batting 424 right now. With four home runs.
Let's raise that average up right here. And get her another home run maybe. A little low. You don't want anything at Abby's waist, that's for sure.
Yeah. Outside. Marley taking a little long again, Abby. See if Abby's got one in her bag right here. 2-0 pitch. Change up. they're probably going to be.
I believe Murray just gave her the green light.
Did he?
Yeah.
There it is. Right there it is, folks.
That's a great call.
Yeah. Hey. You're out of baby.
Good job by Murray giving her the green light
That
3-0.
Yes, sir. I mean, they're going to pipe it almost every time.
Yep. Big hit right there.
Some of that senior magic right there, man.
Yep, maybe that'll get us rolling here.
Rattle the young pitcher.
Yep.
Hopefully. Yeah, Murray said, if you like it, you hit it. She liked it all right.
A little low. Ball one on Aubrey.
A lot of changeups coming up.
Yeah.
Coming to Pogue, man.
Well, she's leading the team in hitting, like I said.
Yeah, exactly. Pitch or good eye. Still outside.
There's a little frustration there. They're not as happy with the strike zone.
It was a ball.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Let's see if it gives her the green light.
Outside.
Well, it's starting to spread a little bit.
Yep.
Coach Morris said timeout.
Ricky calling a little timeout. Yep. We get a courtesy for Aubrey. Little word from our sponsor, State Farm, Daniel Garbarino. D-Garbs, thanks for your sponsorship. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Elk City Summer Softball League, helping build tomorrow's softball leaders. Red Dirt Garage Doors, Mike Adams, the Garage Door Nerds. Anything you need for overhead doors, holler at Mike. Moxie Realty, Amy Robbins. Good job sponsoring your daughter's home run right there.
Yeah.
Moxie makes it happen.
That was the Moxie make it happen. Yep. Big hit right there.
That's right. All right, folks. No outs. Asia Maddox, Kersey running for Aubrey. He's got a walk. Brenna Butler's up. Oh, little blooper. Trouble.
On the line. Yes. Stay there. No, stay there, Asia. Get back.
Oh, she makes it.
That's one of those lucky breaks that we needed, a little blooper.
Yeah.
We don't get those very often.
No.
But sometimes, a lot of times it seems like that's what beats us, these little bloopers
that
hit the line, you know.
No outs. Runners at first and second.
Oh, we got to get that bunt.
Oh, man. This is second time again that Asia didn't read the sign.
Well, I think she thought that bunt was going to get down.
Right.
Murray told her to get here on the bunt.
Yeah.
Well, the bunt did get down.
Yeah.
Which bunting is one of the bunt has to be worked on all the time.
It's just right.
One of the little things that has to get done to win tight games. You got to get the bunt down.
We just can't. That's our third time on bases. We've
made you got to see it. You got to see it.
Yeah.
You got to see the ball down before you take off. I mean, you get your lead and you see it down, and then you go.
Way to swing in through that one. Outside.
Good eye.
Good eye.
We'll take walks.
Yep.
I don't care.
Yep. Weatherford fans a little wanted that call, but it was well off the plate. Oh, got her on the rise.
Dang. All right, Jerry, just got to see it hit the bat.
He's going to provide the speed and power for you. Just put it in play.
Let's go, Jerry!
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh, strike.
I like, yeah. I was like, he's not going to call that one. But he did.
Jerry having a hard time catching up with that speed right now.
Yeah, she's taking the hacks that she needs to take.
And right.
Just pulling off, not seeing it.
Got her for the final out. Ooh, we need to do something there.
Yep.
We'll be back.
Tips Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
J.Y. Dylan Satilli, little noise there in the bottom of the fourth. Yep. Like to have seen a little more. We had some opportunities.
Yeah, we got to get that. I just had to get that bunt down.
Yeah.
And Abby Joe, that was a gutsy call by Murray, just saying, hey.
You got it. Go for it.
Yeah. Gave her the green light.
3-0.
Yeah.
Middle of the lineup here for Weatherford Lady Eagles. Aubrey got one, got away from her. A little high, 2-0.
All right, Poe, just relax, kid.
Mixing feet up.
Good hit.
Oh. That looked good right there.
Yeah.
Called a ball, though. 3-1. Fouled back. Full count.
Oh, we don't throw out one of them new balls.
Yeah. Three and count. 3-2 is the count. No outs. Drew walk.
Can't do that, Jay.
No. Here comes the bunt. Looked like a strike.
They're giving it to Brian.
Good mix change up there. Foul back. Maybe she got the ball she likes there.
Well, yeah.
Got a little wear, a little concrete scuff marks on it.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh,
wow. Was she out? What happened here?
Something happened with her knee.
So on that bunt, BB dove for it.
Came out of her glove.
Came out of her glove.
In fair territory.
Yeah. Then it rolled to Abby Joe, and she kind of booted it.
Yep.
To the backstop.
Right.
And the runner didn't make it, but 15 feet, but she finally got to first base and just kind of collapsed.
Like something happened with her knee. Knee gave out on her, and she just kind of walked down there, and they were all in throw it.
Good effort by BB.
There's another bunt. Move the runners around.
Yeah, good job getting out. Let's see. Do we defend the bunt right here?
This is Daisy Morris, coach's daughter.
Doesn't look like he's got a bunt call on.
Sitting there for a strike.
Low on that outside corner. Try to get you a ground ball right here.
Yep.
Watch your runner.
Oh, my gosh.
Run counted.
BB's got a nose. Man, they did get the final out, though.
Well, back to a two-ball run ball game.
Yeah. Not sure why we threw it that direction, but we'll be back. Craziness here. We are now in the bottom of the fifth. We did get our final out. Madison snuck in from center and got the runner cheating off there, but did get one run across on the great play by BB, and then kind of not knowing where we needed to go with the ball there, Dylan.
Yeah, the runner at third base tagged up on that and then noticed nobody was covering home. She took off, and then BB threw it over towards third because there was a runner kind of going to third. I don't think she noticed the runner coming to home, and there's nobody covering home.
Right.
So it's just a mess, man.
Yeah. You got to know those situations.
Yeah.
Emily Lawrence up second time. Not getting through the lineup near as many times as we normally do, Dylan.
No. This will be our second at bat, right?
Yeah. Yeah, remember she hit that line drive to center field over center's
That's
head.
Good.
Yep. See if she can do it again right here.
She's coming in with some confidence. Should have shout out to the football boys coming out and supporting.
Right.
Had a big win against Canadian Texas last week.
In there for a strike.
I've seen Elo hit a ball like that a long ways before.
Yep. A little high.
Good eye.
1-1. A little playoff atmosphere here, Dylan.
Yeah. Well, I mean, district play.
Yeah.
It's kind of like the playoffs, right?
Yeah. Swinging through that one.
See it straight to it, Elo.
One ball and two strikes, Jimmy Lillerantz. Eight-hole hitter. Yep.
All right, Jill. Be confident. Do your thing, number two.
Right. Jill swinging through it.
Yeah. Good hard cut. A little early on it, really.
You've been struggling a little bit.
Well, yeah.
Confidence.
Yeah, I just got to be up there with a purpose.
Yep.
You know, sometimes I'm maybe she's just swinging to, there you go, good eye.
Yeah.
She saw that one. Hoping she'll hit it. You know, she's under a lot of pressure, you know. She's competing for playing time.
Right.
Makes it hard. Good eye. Get her on base.
Yep. 2-2. Count to Jill.
Bring in birdie.
Good job by that catcher dragging that back across.
Yeah. She made it look pretty.
Made it look closer than it was.
Good eye.
Good eye.
Down and in. Here we go, two. Find your way, kid.
Find a way right here. Big time game when we were 12U against Hammond, and Jill had been struggling like this. And I just told her, I said, baby, I trust you more than anything. And she hit a little blooper over second base, won the game for us. I still remember that.
Yeah.
One of her first. Got her.
Good at bat.
Yep.
Took it the distance.
All right, two outs, bottom fifth.
Let's see if they give birdie lead something up to hit.
Outside. They won't come right.
I don't anticipate them coming at her.
No, I don't think they'll come at the top three much at all. Good pitch right there. 1-1. Nice ball hit deep.
Got a chance
down for the birdie's gonna be up.
Nice job,
on bird. Good job.
I'd like that one to get out.
Yep. We're close.
Well, they got to go talk about it.
Yep.
Well, got a hit on you. Let's talk about it. It happens. Move on. Let's go. Good hard hit by birdie.
Yep. I was afraid he was going to hang up a little long when it took off the bat, but it got deep.
Yeah.
Perfectly in the gap there between left and center.
There we go.
Right off to the edge. Off to direct.
Turning bird.
Come on.
Yeah.
Good job, Riley.
That's two. Good hit by Riles. And look who's up.
Yep.
Good job by Riley taking that pitch the other way.
She giving Birdie a chance.
Yeah. Good eye. Oh.
Called a strike.
All right. May have hit the corner a little bit.
He's definitely on the river.
Abby Joe, mind tricks going on right here.
Well, it's working. For some reason, when she's in there against.
Go, Riley.
Good job.
I think she knew what she was doing before it was ever even thrown.
I know. What do you think?
Yeah.
A little bait and switch there.
Yeah.
Morse has coached her enough. I'm surprised he didn't.
Yeah.
I've heard him tell him time and time again, you got to watch her. She'll steal on you every time.
Sneaky.
All right. Ricky taking another visit to the mound. We'll talk a little bit about sponsors, Snap-on Tools, Levi Cook. Snap-on makes work easier for professionals. Barber Dyson Ford, Bruce Barber, David Corbin Dyson. Experience the difference. And Darko Dozer Trucking, Oklahoma's leading dirt and trucking company. Tips Agency, Justin Twyman, the service you deserve from your insurance agent. Heck of a situation right here.
Yep. Two outs.
Do they put her on?
I don't think he's going to.
One and one's a count.
He may not give her anything to hit.
Yeah. Little outside.
Yeah, here's a little out.
Oh. Two and two to Abby Joe. Come on, baby. Just get something in play right here. Tied up. That's all we need. We don't need a bomb. We just need tied up. Oh, sky's high. Oh, run into each other, but they get an out.
Oh, that would have been big time. Should have dropped that.
Yep. Man. We'll be back. Tied 3-2. Weatherford, top of six.
If your garage door looks like this, there's only one person to call. Red Dirt Garage Doors. They'll literally get you back on track and rolling up and down again. Red Dirt Garage Door does residential and commercial sales and service, serving Southwest Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. You can call for a free estimate at 580-482-6369. That's 580-482-6369. Red Dirt Garage Doors. Keeping you on track and the garage door looking good.
Welcome back. Big, exciting game right here. Tight game. 3-2, Lady Eagles lead the Elk City Elkettes. Top of the sixth, 3-2.
We'd like to get a couple runs, man. Yep. Just a couple more.
Yep.
Abby Joe took a good swing on that ball. Just got under it a little.
Yep.
It was almost trouble. The left fielder and shortstop collided.
See if we can shut them down here. High one, ball one from Aubrey.
Got to go at them here, Obbs.
Oh, good pitch. Yep. Swinging through that. Strike. That's going to be trouble. Oh, got by Jill. Bobbled a little bit. Down the line for a double.
She saved it from getting to the fence, really. Yep. She was running at it, and she just had to knock it down.
Right.
Pretty smart play.
Yep.
Could have been a triple.
Nobody there. Nobody there.
Riley saw the fake bunt shown, and she's like, oh, I got to get over there.
Yeah. Got to play your position.
Had a little fake bunt slash going. Well, that was a little low. That's the one that we got called on us a minute ago.
Yeah.
Nobody out.
Runners on second and third. Got it. Oh, no.
All right. Now we're in a dilemma.
Yep.
Okay. They're going to put her on. Let me get to work for us this time, eh?
Oh.
It's the right move.
Yep.
It's absolutely the right move.
Absolutely the right move.
In my opinion, she's probably the best player in our district, if not one of the best players in all of 4A.
Right. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
Got her. Got her hand on the bag just in time.
Yep. Pass ball. Weatherford's able to score another run. Unusual pass ball. To know the count. I'd like to see Aubrey try to keep some of those up. We seem to have a lot of balls in the dirt. Tag up for another run.
Weatherford's hitters, they're dangerous.
Yep. They've gotten better, too.
Yeah.
Good change up by Aubrey. Gets a better swinging.
Yeah, I would stay out of the dirt.
Yeah.
Got to make it look good.
Yep. That's trouble. Right down the line.
Yeah, we don't cover that line very well. We play the gap.
Yep. Ooh, 6-2. Weatherford. Making it tougher every run, isn't it?
Yeah.
Back to Aubrey for the third out. Whew, tough one.
Wow, yeah.
Tough one. We'll be back.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back. After a tough top of the sixth inning there, we are in the bottom of the sixth. Aubrey Pogues leading us off here.
Get another hit.
Big inning by the Lady Eagles there. We had some mistakes, and they had some very timely hitting.
Yeah. Just some brain farts.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then some really good hits.
Yeah. See if we can get something rolling here. 4, 5, and 6 up.
You know, these pitchers don't like these new balls. They keep switching them out.
Yeah.
We just need to rub them in and get them ready.
Right. Oh, Aubrey's 0-4 today, but had 2 walks.
Okay.
So she's been on base both times, but both times with a walk. BB's 1-for-2. Jada's 0-for-2. And Jerry Moeller is 0-for-2 coming up. So got some work to do.
Absolutely. We've had some really good hits off of Teasley today.
Right.
Just do it at the wrong times.
Right.
You know, without the runners on base and things like that.
Right. Well, we've had
three
base running situations that we've gotten out on.
Yeah.
That sure would like that back.
Yeah.
Critical outs in situations that we didn't need them.
Yep. And getting butts down. There's a
right.
couple of those. They don't want to pitch the nines.
Right. Showing her a lot of respect, aren't they?
Yeah.
Lots of changeups, lots of things in the dirt. There's another one. You reckon Murray will run Asia again?
Gosh. I don't know. She's got speed, man.
She does have speed. Reno to Aubrey. In there for a strike.
Still looking for your pitch, Nines. No need to chase.
We need base runners right here. Oh, yeah, now we're talking trash. The pitcher's just running their mouth a little bit.
It is low.
Yeah, I can't believe that. Have you seen that in a while?
You know, people are just entitled these days, right?
I understand. Come on, BB.
Ball looked down to me.
Foul tipped. 0-2 to BB. Need base runners. There's a base runner. Oh, no. Great catch right there. I thought that was dropping in.
Yeah, left fielder, she wasn't playing as deep as you think she would with BB up. She she's right where she needed to be at,
right.
Actually.
Able to just scoop that off the right before it hit the ground.
Yeah.
One out.
I can scratch a couple across. We're going to that seventh inning. Get it closer to the top of our lineup coming back up.
Right. Sure would like to get a little deeper. One and one to Jada. Jada's capable of getting a hold of one too, you know.
Yeah.
Fouled that one back. We don't see many pitchers that have the movement.
They hate those balls. They don't want them.
Yeah.
Such a big deal. Somebody just needs to spit on them, rub them in.
Come on, Jada. Outside. 2-2.
Come on, kid. Need you on base.
Fouled that last ball back. Deep breath by Jada there. 2-2, one out. Aubrey's still on first.
Good eye.
Yep. Full count.
Of it sometimes.
Nope.
Another rise ball.
Yep. Well, when our hands drop, there's no way we're ever catching it.
No.
We got some girls at the first movement's down.
Yeah.
Trying to pull it, you know.
Yep. Well, there got a hold of one.
Yep.
Foul ball.
0-2.
I mean, you know, coming into the game, one of our keys was don't need a whole lot of strikeouts.
Yep.
Guess how many we have, Jay Wyatt? We have 11. That's a lot of strikeouts.
Outside. 1-1. Sure would like to see Jared find a way to get on here. Having a hard time catching up to it. Oh,
that's smart.
Smart, but
smart.
Yeah.
No need to get that third out.
Yeah.
Not the right time to be pressing.
No. Really wanting to get back to the top of our lineup in the bottom if we can.
Absolutely.
Ooh. Another strikeout. What we talked about, Dylan. Be back in a minute, Mox.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space. And we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Thank you.
Welcome back. J.Y. Dillon Satilli here. We are in the top of the seventh, the final frame.
We need
find ourselves down 6-2. We need to get in and out of this deal without giving up, because it's going to be ultra critical. Catcher is up. Swing in there. Good pitch inside.
Yellow up in the zone.
The outside. Ball one. We got people everywhere. Little girls just hanging out in the out of the batting barn up there.
Oh, good pitch.
No, called a strike.
Good job, Bri.
Good job, Abby Joe, dragging that back in.
It cut across the plate.
Yeah. Oh, fouled out of play.
Good swing on that outside pitch.
Yep.
And that's dangerous. You can hit that pitch, you drive to right field. I mean, that's dangerous. And I know that's something that Coach Morse, I think he pounds that in their hitting sessions.
Right.
To be able to hit that outside pitch.
Low. Two and two the count. No outs.
Good hit.
Good change up. Wicked. Wicked, wicked, wicked. Takes a really disciplined hitter, but you can't take the chance on that being on two strikes. You got to swing, but timing gets all jacked up.
There we go.
Little grounder to Dacey, from Dacey to
Dacey,
Riley.
Dacey hung onto her bat for a little bit.
Yeah. That's what we needed, Dylan.
Hell yeah.
Two quick outs. See if we can make it happen here.
It's around where we started last inning, I think.
Oh, man, hit batter. Didn't need that right there.
No.
This is a girl they call KK. Off in the bat, foul.
Yeah, this girl's been around a little bit. She came in one year and got a really good hit off of Danny a few years ago. And the rest of the girls from Weatherford wasn't really hitting that game, but she came in as an extra hitter or designated hitter at some point, and she
got a big bat.
Yeah, she drove some balls in the center field.
One and one's count. Two outs. Little dribbler. Good job, Aubrey.
Good job,
make
Pogue.
Play. Good job by Pogue. We'll be back for the final opportunity for the Elkettes.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
I don't know if he'd do it, but that would be...
That's what I would do, but.
Well, Jay, here we are, man.
Mm-hmm.
Seventh inning.
Yep.
D'Lo had a big hit earlier.
What is she, one for two? Or one for three? No, one for two.
Yeah.
Had a strikeout last time.
Strikeout, yeah.
Yeah.
Straight to it, Elo, you got it.
I mean, I know it'd be tough batting for Jill. You know, you want your senior stepping up and doing that.
Mm-hmm.
She's been struggling seeing the ball today. Here we go. Low in there, ball one. How many pitches has Marley thrown, Dylan?
Number
88.
That's a, inside. That's a really low pitch count.
Yeah. I mean, Pogue's at 100 and what? No, she's under 100. 98.
98. Good aggressive approach.
Yeah, good rip. Elo there. Quick hands. Quick
yeah.
hands. Change up.
Nasty.
Yep. Dollars to donuts, we see it here too.
Got her on the rise ball. Same one last time.
Down to our final two outs here, folks. Jill Metter. Just got to believe, baby. It's your time.
Good eye.
Change up outside. Oh, no.
That's some chalk there, Brian.
Come on, Brian.
Good eye.
1-1 count.
That one had a little bit on it right there.
Yep.
Could have been a 61, 62 mile per hour pitch.
Just tell by Jill's approach, her head.
Yeah, she's down.
Confidence.
There,
man. Got her swinging.
There's Birdie. She's
yep.
sitting with a lot of confidence. She gets going with two outs, top of the lineup. You know, wherever we end up in district, we're going to be a lot of trouble. Or, you know, regionals, wherever we end up, you know.
Strike. Well, we definitely got to hit the ball all the way through the lineup. Can't have 13, 15 strikeouts a game.
No. I mean, Teasley's proven herself to be one of the best pitchers.
Yep.
Probably in 4A.
Well, you've got her on the mound, and then you got, you know, their shortstop. Probably the one, like I said, maybe the best player in 4A. Little chopper, going to be a tough one. Ball game. Well, we'll be back.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the company's run. with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back, J.Y. Dylan Satilli. Disappointing loss there, right there, Dylan.
Yeah, like, you know, we talked about it. Walks, strikeouts, and errors.
Yep.
It'll get you.
Just a tough day, you know. Six hits is all we had total.
I don't think Weatherford, they might only had seven.
That's right. They only had seven hits, but they scored six runs.
They did, because of the walks and errors.
That's right. We only had three walks and had 14 strikeouts and six hits, two runs. You know, just a tough day for everybody at the plate.
Yeah. Hats off to Weatherford, man.
Yeah, they've got a really good team. And, you know, we had some base running situations that we didn't do well on. We had, you know, we got three outs on base running errors.
Yeah.
And those are killer, you know. And, you know, Aubrey threw a workman-type game. I mean, six strikeouts, five walks, seven hits, threw 98 pitches.
Yeah, not too bad.
I mean,
bad at all.
You know, you just got to put the bat on the ball. We had
all types of chances to score.
That's right.
Four or five more runs.
That's right. We just when we get down to the bottom of our lineup, we struggle and pushing runners across. Our 6, 7, 8, 9 hitters were 1 for 12. That's a killer. So, you know, appreciate everybody coming out today. Had a great crowd supporting the girls. Hopefully we can keep our heads up, make some noise going forward.
Yeah.
We still have Anadarko.
Got a festival coming up.
Got a festival at
Pioneer.
Pioneer.
Yeah, little country school up by Enid.
That's right. We will be on the air 4:30 and
4 and 6.
4 and 6.
I think so.
So on Saturday. So y'all tune in and we will be up there. Dylan and I will be. So we'll be hoping you'll be able to tune in with us. And that'll be about it. Not the turnout not the end we wanted here. So definitely have to do some regrouping for playoffs.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So
we'll be all right, man.
Appreciate you watching. We'll see you Saturday. Have a great day.
Thank you for tuning in to this presentation of Elk City Athletics, presented by the Bank of Western Oklahoma, where people come first. Big Elk TV and Cool 94 are a part of the Paragon Communications Network, and any distribution or rebroadcast without permission is strictly prohibited. Paragon Communications is owned and operated by Blake Brewer. General Manager is Gabe Edney. Sports Director, Sean Wilson. Once again, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, go Big Elks.